which we have to recite in day. So these problems are there, which are very complex, but still the Shastra say that they are for advanced people, number one. Second thing, they are very simply manageable by means of our prayer and mantras. So we need not go for search and research at all. So this is known as Dravya, Dravya Niyama. Fourth thing is Krama Niyama, how to eat. There is a position for eating, but if you eat like that, it will take hours together. But still we can try, I think. So to take the food and to do that Pancha Prana Huti, then Pariseshana, everything, etc. Then take the food, first think about the food, you must taste and relish the food. And there is an inner taste of food, nobody is relishing that. Inner taste of the food, for example, you know that if you take banana, the banana is having a skin. What is the taste of the skin? So it is having one more peripheral epidermis. It is known as carpiti. Carpiti is the level of a fruit. It is known as carpus in Greek language. They used to say carpus and carpiti. Carpiti is the system by which a fruit is made. And this carpiti, it has a peripheral skin surface. That will not be tasty. The second layer is the prodermic layer is that will not be tasty. The inner layer will be tasty like that. So you have to understand, whenever you are munching or relishing the food, initially you are getting the ingredient taste. That is known as an initial taste. Then after masticating, that mixes with your lingual juice or sublingual juice, that is the saliva. Then it is processed. Then only the inner real flavor that comes. But we don't wait for that time. Immediately it is put inside. Nobody, I believe that, except few people, nobody, they have never tasted the real flavor of food. That is Antar Ruchi. Our Vishishta Ruchi has not been taken. Everybody is taking only the Sharirak Ruchi. They are not considering about the Antarik Ruchi. So we have to taste that. Then it should be forwarded to this canal. Then it should go inside. So that is known as the Krama. So we have to take it, taste it, find out the inner or the finer taste or the finest taste of offering. That's what I told in my lecture on this Pancha Diksha, which is conducted at Rajbar. I told a devotee should be able to distinguish, closing the eyes, which is homemade food, which is hotel made food, and which is a hermit made food, and which is a food made at a holy place like temple. So holy food, hermitage food, hotel food and home food, these four H must be distinguishable for a person who has spiritual identity. Without saying. So that cannot be possible by means of our mere vision or our peripheral vision or scrutiny, because most of the places, the hotel food may be nicer than a home or even a holy place. So to taste that inner ingredient, we need a different taste bud, which I am going to say today. So this is known as Krama. And then Upadana, which is the best container to cook or to eat. The Shastra says that there are a lot of subtle laws while we are cooking in some ingredients. Now it has become, everything has become microwave oven is there, then pressure cooker is there. If we go too much inside, then we will feel like vacating the houses and going somewhere. So Bhartana Shastra says, at least at the time of puja, at least at the time of good things, mud is preferable. Even in temple they used to make it with mud pots. See, whenever people were handling mud pots, it was developing the pottery, number one. Number two, it was developing care, meticulous care and handling technology and patience with people. Without patience, without handling skill and tactics, or without having that type of observation and these things, vigilance, you cannot handle those issues. So at that time, patience developed and pottery also developed. Now pottery is also not there, patience has also gone out of people. So that thing, occasionally we have to use that. At least at the time of any special festivals and occasions, we have to use that. Plant and leaf. Nobody is using plant and leaf. Because of non-availability, they are saying. Somebody said to me, as they are not available, we are not using. Then I told that, reciprocate it. As you are not properly using, those issues have become obsolete and non-available. The more you use them, the more you honor them, more their productivity will be there. That is our Vedantic vision. And the more they are available, we can use. That is a modern vision. It is a very, very wrong ideology. More you honor things, automatically it will usher up the people to do some sort of productivity. It will instigate the productivity at all. So the other thing is Ahara Gati. What is Ahara Gati? It has three gatis. I have already told. One is Asya Gati, and second is marga gati, third is the kukshi gati. There are innumerable hormones and enzymes, there are Sanskrit equivalents for that. Each and everything what it is doing with the food is there. What are all the dust and dirt, it is removed by one enzyme. What are all the insolubles, they are made soluble in one enzyme. Wherever those things are not breakable by the intestinal juice, those things are broken. See, elementary school teacher prepares the child to go for high school teacher for higher secondary, they for college. Like that, this preparation inside makes it to travel inside the food canal. And here it is made for intestine. Intestine makes it very sufficiently adaptable for the bodily enzymes through blood supply. So these things, hundreds of enzymes are there. They make solubility, they make compatibility, they make toxic reduction, they make toxic excretion, they make energy boosting, they make energy adaptability to various things. There are soft tissues, softer tissues, softest tissues. So based on their saushtava, based on their mardava, based on their svikriti, these things are tuned by various juices inside, which are having Sanskrit equivalent names as well as equivalent deities also, with mantras and other things. So it is known as gati. And Shastra says, whatever the food that you take, it has three pathways. One is guna marga, second is mala marga, third is urja marga. Whatever that is going inside the body, that is known as urjas. Whatever that is coming out of the body, that is known as mala, excretion. Whatever that is going inside your spirit in the form of a cloud with the qualities or characteristic determination, that is known as guna. So if you take a food, one third of the food, that goes as guna. What is that guna? Sattvika, rajasa and tamasa. That's why our shastra say that your character is determined by the food. Then why people are eating food and behaving different? There are a lot of non-vegetarians who are very silent, patient and helping others. Lot of people are there. And there are a lot of vegetarians who are, most of the people, most of the great dictators and most of the great autocratic and tyrant people, there have been a lot of people who are vegetarians and fruitarians. Even that Veerappan, who was very famous in Tamil Nadu, we claim that he was not a vegetarian, but he is a great worshipper. So worship, vegetarianism, these things are available even with cruel people. How it is possible? Is it a mismatch or something? We want to say, if in this Janma he is having vegetarianism or something, that is a prarabdha samskara. That is, he has started vegetarian now. That vegetarianism practice has been started now. It is known as arabdha. What is it known as? Arabdha. Just now it has started. Whatever he is behaving now is prarabdha, that which has started earlier. Purvameva arabdha. Yakramaha prarabdha. Praharshena purvam arabdha prarabdha. Sadhyaha sampratika arabdhihi arabdha. That which has started now, that is known as arabdha. That which has started earlier and the maturity is manifesting now, that is prarabdha. So this is how Shastra's answer. So if a person is vegetarian, still he is very arrogant, still he is ferocious. If he is a non-vegetarian, he would have been more. If a non-vegetarian, if he is very amicable, compassionate and everything, etc., if he is tuned with the food habits also, the qualities will be intensified. This is how we want to say. So food is having sattvika, rajasa, tamasa. That we have to identify, that we will discuss in the lessons. So these are all the various basic pillars of the food science. That is the ahara lakshana, ahara dravya, ahara adhikara, ahara vibheda, ahara parishkara, ahara gati, ahara vidhi. So it deals with modern concepts. All encompassingly we have to say in English, we can deal with food.